One day, when I was an elementary schooler, I think probably third or fourth grade, I was awoken by my mom in a rush. She had overslept, and since she always woke me up in the morning, this meant that I too overslept. And now there was just no way I was going to be ready for school early enough to get on the school bus. School started at 8 a.m., and my bus pickup time was 7 a.m. But it was already like 6:40 or something, and I was still in my pajamas and hadn't even had breakfast yet. So my mom decided that today, we would just tell the bus driver to go on ahead. She would take me to school, which would give me plenty of time to get ready. So I'm just sitting there at the dining room table eating breakfast, still in my pajamas. And it's now about 6:50. We hear the bus pull up, about 10 minutes earlier than usual. My mom peeks her head out the door, into the foggy morning, and waves the bus on. She closes the door and comes back inside, but the bus doesn't pull away. There's a knock at the door, and my mom opens it to find a man in a bus driver uniform. He explains that he's a substitute driver because the regular driver called in sick. He says he knows he's a few minutes early since he wanted to get an early start on the route since he didn't know it well. My mom explains to him that she was going to take me to school since we woke up late. He gets visibly upset and says that he can wait a few minutes since he's already running ahead of schedule. My mom insists that no, I won't be ready to go in a few minutes and tells him to go on ahead. He seemed angry about this, but turned around and got back in the bus and left. I return to eating my breakfast and still don't have my school clothes on at this point. But at 7 in the morning sharp, another bus pulls up to my house. My mom thinks this is weird and goes outside to talk to them. She comes back inside looking terrified, but doesn't really say anything about it and tells me to finish getting ready for school. At the time, I didn't know what happened, but my mom would end up telling me a few years later. When she went to the second bus, she found out that it was being driven by my regular bus driver, and it was full of all the other kids that usually are on the route. The other bus was empty, by the way. My mom asked the driver about the substitute driver and about him calling in sick. I never called in sick, and there's no substitute driver on my route, he says. The driver immediately called dispatch in a panic and told my mom to go inside and call the police, which she did without me knowing, and report this incident. There was absolutely no one doing my driver's route that day. Whoever this was most likely a kidnapper who had targeted me. I never heard anything about it again. Not even if someone else had ended up being picked up by this mysterious fake bus driver. But chances are, had I gotten on that bus, I would have never made it to school or back home. And if my mom hadn't overslept on that specific day, I would have been on that bus. I was 8 or 9 at the time. I was an extremely skinny, small little girl for my age. I hung out at the very bottom of the height and weight charts at the doctor's office. Adults would often mistake me for a child of 6, which I absolutely hated. It was summertime and my mom was home making lunch. I asked to go ride my bike. The rule was not around the block, just at the corner and back. We lived in a very small, quiet town on the street that hardly ever had traffic unless it was the neighbors coming and going. My corner was about 8 houses down from my own house. I was cruising along on my new bike, and I didn't quite hit the bumpy spot in the sidewalk correctly, and I crashed pretty hard. I was laying there all twisted around, with my bike shaking. My helmet had fallen off because I never buckled the bottom strap to be cool. I felt all shaky, and then I worried I'd get in trouble for not buckling my helmet strap, assuming my mom saw me. Maybe 30 seconds passed, and a car drove up to me at the corner. I heard a car stop and a man's voice say, "Oh, honey, are you okay?" I was trying not to cry at this point. I look up expecting a neighbor, and I see a stranger. This man looked dirty, and you could see all kinds of garbage all inside his car. The garbage was right up to all the windows, and the car was rusty. He had pulled his car right over in such a way that he was almost right on the sidewalk in front of me. He had stayed in his car, but he was leaning way out of his driver's side window and his door was a little open looking at me. He then said, "Come on, I'll take care of you." I lied and I said I wasn't hurt. He got angry with me and said he'd just take me home. I remember thinking, where would I sit? I said to him, "I'm not hurt." Then he said, "If you're not hurt, you have to prove it." So I took all my strength and I untangled my legs and stood up. Then the man gave me a terrible, angry look and peeled out and disappeared. I was so scared I took my shaky legs and I ran home crying. I left my helmet and my bike laying there. I tell my mother what had happened and she walked down and grabbed my bike and helmet after lunch. As an adult, I asked her if she remembered that incident. She told me that when she walked to the corner to grab my things, she saw the tire tracks right up to the sidewalk. The car had pulled way over across where I must have fallen, and it also blocked me from view of anyone else driving by. She thought maybe the man would have kidnapped me, but she wasn't sure. I was told that he probably just wanted to help. Then I was told again to not talk to strangers. If I need help, then I can only talk to a mommy with kids. I think that dirty-looking man wanted to take me. He probably saw what he thought was a 5 or 6-year-old and was disappointed when I wasn't young enough and hurt enough to easily get picked up. Still creeps me out thinking how angry he got at me. If he'd been a tiny bit nicer, I might not be alive today. I was always an extremely small and sickly child. I looked young for my age. My family and I lived out of town, about 8 miles out. Our little community was next to a highway. The school bus would drop me off 2 blocks away from home. One day, I noticed a red truck following slowly behind me, so slow that I figured they were just looking for a house or something. I ignored it and walked to my house. That was the end of that. Consistently, this truck would follow slowly behind me. After a couple days of this, I walked into my house. I was always the first one home and looked out the window. Inside was an older man in a black lab. He was staring at me, idling inside his truck. Then he pulled away. I decided enough was enough. I told my parents. Of course, my sister was quick to jump in that I was lying. I had a habit of telling stories, but my mom thankfully believed me. She drove me to the bus stop the next morning. The red truck was there, across the street at the gas station, pointing toward the bus. I got on the bus and my mom decided to drive around the truck. She described the scene. The man was disheveled and dirty, hunched over in his seat, just staring at the bus. His license plates were caked in mud, so she couldn't make them out. Freaked her out so much that she called the police and the school. I went to school and was quickly pulled into the office. The man had been spotted at the school, waiting in his truck. That day I rode the bus home. This time the truck was parked alongside the street. I would have to walk past this man's driver's side door to get home. I debated, considered running for it. Apparently, this man was getting desperate now that he was spotted. Police car showed up and I talked to the policeman. They went to go talk to the man. He quickly pulled away from the curb and took off down the highway. Never saw him again, and I don't believe he was ever caught. Because of this experience, I'm extremely guarded and paranoid with my own daughter and her soon-to-be sibling. The world is a terrifying place these days, and children go missing so easily. I don't like to think about it. If I had been grabbed, I wouldn't be here typing this. My kids wouldn't exist. While I was lucky, many children aren't. When I was like 6 years old, I attended the elementary school, which was located in our small town. My way to and from school was basically just 500 meters off the main road, before turning into the street where I lived. At the time, we're talking about the late 90s here. All the parents in the town were extremely adamant on telling their kids not to trust or follow strangers. Never to get into anybody's car, even if they say they know your parents and they're friends. The reason why, there was a murder like 3 years back in the same town. A girl, not even 6 years old, was found dead and sexually assaulted in a field. The strange thing about it is, nobody knows how exactly she was taken. No signs of forced entry or something, which implied somebody lured her somewhere without her suspecting a thing. The case still hasn't been solved more than 20 years later. So our parents were very afraid that their kid was going to be next, because kids can be really stupid and you can't watch them 24/7. Now, on to what happened to me. I was walking home from elementary school. About halfway home, at the shadiest and mostly covered by trees and bushes area, car pulled up next to me. A blonde, about 30-ish woman was the driver. She told me she could drive me home. She claimed to be going in the direction anyway, which was unclear to me at the time, essentially bullshit, because once the road ends near my house, there's nothing but empty fields. Being a kid and not being suspicious at all, I said, "Oh no, it's not that far, I can walk." Then she started being more insistent, the whole time, "Oh, come on, it's fine, nothing to worry about, and you can relax instead of walking," kind of thing. The alarm bells only started ringing when she said she knew my mother. They were friends, and supposedly she was asked by her to drive me home. Thank God for my parents repeatedly talking about the tricks that people use to lure you in. I started being creeped out, continued to walk, but she kept driving beside me. Now, the real weird part in hindsight was her next attempt to get me into the car. She started saying that I was obviously afraid, and cool children are not afraid of such things. If you want to be cool, you should just relax. Honestly, I did not fully realize the full extent of the situation. I just felt uncomfortable and wanted to get out of the conversation. So I just started sprinting the rest of the way back to my house. Once I got home, I stayed right next to my door, kept looking outside the window for a few minutes. And guess who drove by and basically checked out the house? The creepy woman. The road was a dead-end road, and only after 3 more minutes the car came back the same way. It took years until I realized what kind of bullet I dodged there. All I was thinking was, my parents told me not to do this. I didn't know why or what the woman wanted. The drill of hearing over and over again not to believe strangers or get into their car kicked in. When I was older and started to get into true crime, I remembered this whole thing for the first time in 2 decades. Then I realized, holy shit, that woman was most likely sent as the trustworthy front woman to lure kids into their car and take off. She could have been doing this for some crazed pedo or human trafficking ring. Moral of the story is, even if your kids are too stupid or young, like I was, to comprehend such things, the rules of not following strangers, and the fact that strangers will lie to you for evil intentions, must be drilled into your child's head like watching both ways when crossing the road. Hey guys, just wanted to take a quick second and say thank you for all the likes, comments, subscribes, the feedback, and kind messages. I really appreciate it, and it encourages me to keep making more content for you guys. I know originally I said I was going to post about 100 videos this year, but I feel more motivated to go even beyond that because of you guys. So if you're new to the channel or haven't done so yet, please hit that subscribe button and that notification bell to get updates on my newest videos. Thanks again.